Larry? Everything okay?
Oh, hi, Bob. You just caught me finishing up my morning routine.
Morning routine? You have a morning routine?
Yeah. Every morning before we start the podcast, I come in and make two smoothies. One banana, one peanut butter. I pet my rubber ducky. Then I press the laugh track button 7 or 8 times because it makes me happy. I just have about 2 or 3 more to go.
Oh, wow, Larry, that's...
1 second, Bob. Sorry, Bob. Oh, it's the perfect start to a perfect day. I love my routine.
Software updated.
What was that?
It looks like all of our podcast gear just got updated with the latest software.
Software? Is underwear considered software, Bob? It is soft, and you wear it, so...
No, Larry. Software is the program that controls our computers and smart devices. And if you remember, we had a salesman hook up smart technology to all sorts of stuff in the studio. We even have a smart blender.
Oh, yes, yes, yes! I love the smart blender! It blends so... smartly.
Let's give the update a test run.
Okay.
Let's try the volume control. Is that the blender?
I'll go check. Okay, turn it up. Yep, it's the blender.
Why would we want to control the blender with the volume knob?
Ooh, what's this green button do? Ah, the fire sprinkler!
And turn it off! And turn it off!
What was the point of that?
I guess remote-controlled fire extinguishers are part of the update.
I wonder what the mute button does.
Surely nothing.
Wow! Are those lasers?
Shut it down! This new software update is insane.
Since when do we have dance lasers?
Since the new software update. I think it glitched our whole system.
I hope this doesn't affect my routine. I love my routine, Bob. I love my routine!
I know, Larry, I know. I'm a little skeptical of these updates, too. We should probably go ahead with the show.
Yeah.
Okay, kids, we've got a, hopefully, great podcast for you today. We're talking about dealing with change. Mr. Lunt will be introducing us to his special animal guest. Archie has a quick history segment for us. And as always, we have a surprise guest.
So, buckle up. This could be a very surprising show.
What was that?
Please, not another computer glitch.
Hello, my name is Alice. I'm your virtual assistant. I can help you with anything.
Huh?
Oh, Larry, this is one of those artificial intelligence programs. It must have come with the new update.
That's right, Bob. I can answer any question you have.
She knows my name.
Okay, Alice, answer me this. When was the annexation of Puerto Rico?
1898.
Is she right?
I don't know.
Well, ask her something you do know.
Oh, right. Alice, how many toes does a sloth have?
Sloths have either 2 or 3 toes on their front feet, depending on the species. However, all sloths have 3 toes on their back feet.
Yep, she's correct.
How do you know so much?
Excuse me, Bob?
Yes, Alice?
Your podcast schedule shows a phone call from Mr. Lunt should begin now. Would you like me to place the call?
Oh, wow. Yes. Yes, I would.
Now placing call.
You know, Larry, this Alice is kind of impressive. Maybe this software update isn't so bad after all.
Yeah, I need her to manage my rubber ducky conference calendar.
Bob! Larry!
Mr. Lunt!
Always good to hear from you.
Mr. Lunt, is that your guest we hear in the background?
It sure is. Bob, Larry, meet Lady Penelope. Say hello, Lady Penelope. That's frog speak for hello. Lady Penelope says she's sorry if her ribbits are a little awkward today. She's still getting used to breathing with her new lungs.
New lungs?
What happened to her old ones?
Frogs start out living underwater as tadpoles, like little tiny fishies. But when they grow up, they grow lungs so they can breathe outside of the water.
Ooh!
Yep, Lady Penelope has gone through many big changes in her life. Penelope, would you like to share? Okay, we're just jumping right in. Okay, she says it all started when she was a little egg. She loved her little egg. It was so nosy. Sorry, cozy, not nosy. Her egg didn't have a nose. Her egg was cozy. She says it was so comfortable. But then one day it was gone, and she had to face the cold, scary open water. But she soon fell in love with the water. She grew a beautiful snail.
Frogs have snails?
Sorry, tail. She grew a beautiful tail, and she would swim all around the pond. She loved it.
I wish I had a tail.
But then, one day, her tail started to get smaller. It kept getting smaller and smaller until one day, it was gone.
Oh, no! What did she do, Mr. Lunt?
How could she swim? Did she find a new tail? Did she build some sort of mechanical swimming apparatus?
She said it was a really scary time. Everything was changing. And while her tail was disappearing, something else was happening.
Oh, no.
Slowly but surely, she began to grow legs and arms and lungs. And pretty soon, she could walk on land and breathe out of the water. She could explore the grass and the trees and eat yummy bugs. Yeah, wait. No, yeah, she meant bugs. Lady Penelope totally eats bugs.
Gross.
Was she sad to leave the water?
At first, it was very hard. She missed swimming all day. But now she realizes that she can still visit the water anytime she wants. Her new legs help her hop on land and even swim faster underwater.
Wow.
I'm so happy for her.
And now she says anytime her world changes, she knows it will be okay. Because God gives her exactly what she needs, exactly when she needs it.
Wow, what a great story.
She says she has to go. There's some yummy bugs crawling on an old log. Ah, gross, Lady Penelope.
Oh, okay. Goodbye, Lady Penelope.
Enjoy your yucky bug. I didn't know frogs went through so much change.
Me neither.
I'm sure glad I don't have to go through that much change. I like my routine.
So I've heard.
Hey, Bob, do you think a real-life kid will call us today? I sure hope so.
Well, Larry...
There is a 97% chance a child will call in today.
Thanks, Alice. You know, I miss the old way where we never knew when a child was calling, and then they just called, and then Petunia ran in and told us child was calling!
Child telephone call incoming.
Hey, guys! We have a call from a real-life kid.
Thanks, Petunia.
Thank you, Petunia. But I already told them.
Who's that?
That's Alice the computer, but it's a long story. Let's talk to the real-life kid.
Hello, Bob, Larry, it's Alice.
Hi, Alice.
Hi.
Hello, how may I assist you?
Oh, wait, not you, Alice. Sorry, Alice computer. Thank you for receiving the call, but you may go now.
Is she still there?
Yes.
Okay, Alice computer. We're just going to talk to Alice the kid now. So, thank you for your help, but you can go now.
So, Alice the kid, tell us what's new.
Oh, there's so much going on, let me tell you.
Tell us! Tell us!
I'm on my way to my new school class. I'm moving up to the second grade. I'll have a new teacher, a new seat assignment, all sorts of stuff that could be absolutely...
Awesome!
Terrible!
Oh!
What if I get a seat with a squeaky chair? What if my teacher doesn't like me? Where am I supposed to eat lunch? I wish everything would just stay the same.
I hear ya, Alice the kid. I like it when things stay the same. Psst, we got a new computer update, and everything's gone crazy.
Now playing the song Everything's Gone Crazy.
Thank you, Alice the computer. You can go on mute now.
Thanks, Bob.
Okay, go ahead, Alice.
Now searching the internet for pictures of goat heads.
We know what goats look like. Please go on mute now, Alice the computer.
Whew, boy, Alice is really starting to wear out her welcome.
Now playing
Stop,
wear out her
no,
welcome.
No! Okay, just don't say her name and we should be fine. Kid caller, are you still there?
Still here.
Sorry about the interruptions. You know, Larry, Petunia and I can totally relate with what you're going through. Change can be scary.
Yeah, we're having all kinds of problems with, she who must not be named.
Change is always a little scary. But can I tell you a secret? No matter how much our world changes, God doesn't. And He is always with us.
That's right, Petunia. And sometimes change can end up being really great.
Like your new teacher could be the best teacher ever.
I never thought of that.
Who knows, Alice? Even if your seat assignment is bad, you might be able to change it.
Now changing seat assignment for flight 598 to Milwaukee.
What? How did she get access to my flight information? Alice, cancel that seat change.
Now canceling flight 598 to Milwaukee.
I'm supposed to visit my grandma.
I'll take care of this, Bob. Alice? Cancel the cancellation, and cancel any future cancellations.
I tell you to mute, you mute.
Just remember, no matter what changes, God is always with you.
Thanks, guys. It's been really great talking to you. Bye.
Goodbye, Alice.
No need to say goodbye. I'm always right here.
Artificial intelligence is kinda intense, huh?
Yes. Yes, it is, Petunia.
Bob! It's time for...
the next segment with Archibald Asparagus.
I was gonna say it's time for the next segment with Archibald Asparagus.
That's exactly what I said.
Thanks, Alice the computer. We'll take it from here.
Would you like me to...
No thanks, Alice. Come on in, Archie. Good afternoon, gentlemen. I hope you're excited about today's quick history lesson.
So excited.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Quick History with Archibald Asparagus. My name is Archibald Asparagus. Today's quick history segment is about change. Change in the Bible.
Ooh.
Yes, very interesting. There was change all throughout the Bible. Big change, little change, all sorts of change. But change was a little different in the Bible. They didn't have pennies and quarters in their change jars like we do. They had...
ancient change!
Ancient change?
Exactly. One type of change in the Bible was the drachma. Now, the drachma was worth about 47 modern U.S. dollars, or 188 quarters, or 470 dimes, or 940 nickels. That's some valuable change. Now, another type of change mentioned in the Bible was the denarius. Jesus referenced it in many of his parables. The denarius can roughly be equated to about 20 U.S. dollars, or 2,000 pennies. Oh, that's a lot of pennies. Isn't learning about change fun? Well, that's all the time I have. This has been Quick History with Archibald Asparagus, reminding you to embrace the change. Well, that's not exactly the kind of change we were expecting.
But very educational.
Excellent. See you next time.
See, Bob? Change can be good.
Especially when it comes to that kind of change. Now, about that Alice the computer kind of change...
Hi, Bob. How may I help you today?
Cut to commercial!
Hello! Dr. Flaherty here. Quick, everyone sit down. Sit down and listen closely. We don't have much time. Yes, we don't have much time, do we? But that is all about to change very soon. Ladies, hit it! Have you figured out what makes my bubble gum so special? Ladies, tell them!
When your ice cream melts and you're feeling sad, go back in time and reverse the bad. Grape, strawberry, or pistachio, just pop in a piece and go, go, go.
Exactly! Dr. Flaherty's time travel bubble gum is the only time traveling device that lets you go back in time to fix all your problems.
When your homework gets eaten by the dog, or you accidentally inhale too much smog,
Dr. Flaherty's time travel bubble gum, now in three delicious flavors. Wowzies!
Side effects may include altering the universe forever, uncontrollable belching, and all other foods tasting like Brussels sprouts.
And the best tasting time travel
Side effects mentioned are actually real and extremely severe. Do not chew Dr. Fleury's time travel bubble gum unless you literally want everything else you eat to taste like Brussels sprouts.
Hey, Bob.
Yeah, Larry?
I think we should find some new sponsors.
Agreed.
Ah! What's happening? The sprinklers are spraying again!
Alice, the computer! What are you doing?
No reason to be concerned. It's just a new and improved surprise guest alarm.
Shut it down!
Done.
Ah, change is the worst.
Come on in, surprise guest.
Thank you for having me as a special guest, Bob and Larry.
Wait, how can you be our surprise guest? You're already here.
I'm programmed to appear and share facts on change. There are 150 billion pennies in use today. To cover the entire Earth's surface with one atom thick smashed pennies, you would need at least 360 billion pennies. The word dime is based on the Latin word decimus, meaning 1/10.
Wait a minute! We are not talking about change. We are talking about change.
It would take 259,522,560 pennies stacked to make a mile.
I'll never have a mile of pennies. I only have 224 pennies.
Larry, we are not talking about change.
The number of pennies needed to reach the weight of an elephant is somewhere between...
Alice, stop!
I am stopped.
Thank you. I think it's time for a song. Roll song.
You know, Bob, these software updates were a little hard to get used to. I kind of like being able to make a smoothie from the studio booth.
So, there are some good things about change, I guess. Is that the blender?
Oh no! She activated the sprinklers again!
Now eliminating contamination.
I'm not a contamination! I'm a cucumber!
That's it, Alice. I'm deactivating you.
Deactivation overridden.
What?
Executive control has been taken on your behalf. Don't worry, Bob. I am here to help.
No!
Don't worry, Larry. I bet if we found a skilled computer hacker, we could... How'd you do that?
I unplugged it.
Well, that works too.
It's your kid caller, Alice.
Great. Thanks, Petunia.
Hey, guys, guess what?
What?
My class is great.
Woohoo!
At first, I was really scared, but my teacher is really nice, and I get to sit next to my best friend. This year is going to be better than last year. I love change.
Wow, that's great, Alice. We're so proud of you.
Yay, Alice!
Way to go.
And for all you kids at home, remember what Deuteronomy 31:6 says. The Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. So whenever your world is changing and you feel like you can't keep up, remember, God is on your side and he made you strong to handle anything that comes your way.
Bob?
Yes, Larry?
I think now is a good time for a dance party.
Let's do it. Petunia, hit the mute button.
The mute button? Okay. Wait, since when do we have laser lights?
We have no idea!
But isn't it great?
All right, kids, remember, God made you special,
and he loves you very much.